Because we live in a world where language has been corrupted and we live in a world of total conceptual confusion and deliberate misrepresentation of people's points of view, I think it's sometimes imperative to stress the obvious. When you say you are against forced integration, it's important to also say you're also against forced segregation. So I'm sure you don't agree with the white supremacist alt-right, which would want, for example, laws against what they would call miscegenation. That is equally repulsive to the libertarian ideal. I'm sure you feel that way. It's absolutely important to stress the obvious, no matter how obvious.
It's obvious. I think I did make clear where I disagree with at least parts of the alt-right. I mean, if you want to have a white national state, what do you do with people who live there right now who do not fall into that category? As I emphasized, we have to blame first of all our white leaders for the evil that we are confronted with. It is Mrs. Merkel who bears most of the responsibility for the immigration crisis that we have in Europe. You can hardly blame those people coming if she says, you come and we will feed you. I would probably come too and want to be fed if somebody invites me at the expense of other people to come. Most of the blame has to be put on the white leaders in our countries who have caused this entire mess. And given that, the position that some alt-right people take sounds ridiculous to me. The idea of socialism, classical socialism, was also an idea that was, after all, created by white males. My emphasis was only, yes, we have to see who have these people chosen as the groups that they want to destroy in order to increase their own power. So it is white males, so to speak, who try to undermine the homogeneity of societies in order to gain more power through the classical policy of divide the people as much as possible, make them all dependent on the state in order to increase our own powers.